Yoyipad experts, welcome to the Yoyipad learner channel. Thank you very much for subscribing my channel. So today we will see about the concept called in the under Yoyipad automation, under app applications, you have a different kind of activities. So what it will do, so we'll just use the one activity called, so the interesting activity, take a screenshot. Okay, it's really an amazing thing. See here, take a screenshot, just drag and drop the text screenshot, and this text screenshot, so let us see what it is saying. So include the, okay, so we should include this one. Okay, so this scope, and this also, it's a very interesting thing. Okay, so let us take this one, an application. So you can indicate application, Windows application, web application. So automatically it will take, okay, so it will act like a attach browser and open browser. Okay, attach window and open in window. Okay, so see, so normally we have attach browser, right? Attach open application, attach window, open browser, right? There is all four things are there, but the four things it will basically, it is a automatically the single application automatically takes. Okay, so it will act like a browser. Okay, suppose for example I'm just closing the internet, what is that, Notepad. Okay, so let us dot run. If it's not there, it will open. Okay, let's dot run, it's already open. If you run, what it will do? It won't do anything. So that means it will act on that particular application. Okay, so that's the beauty of this. Let us take a screenshot. Take a screenshot. So this is which one? Image. I'm just taking the take a screenshot on this image or the whole thing. Okay, basically anything. Okay, so validate and check the what is the validation. Score is 100%. Strike the screenshot. So here, so you can save as an image object, you can save the image into the clipboard, and you can save as a file. See, so today we will see about the only the take screenshot. Okay, normally how you are taking the screenshot into your project. Okay, so if you want to do the take a screenshot in the your projects, what you have to do, you have to use a take screenshot that output is the image object. So again, save image activity, save the image, and while you are saving, you have to give the some pattern like a, so date and time or the number increment, these things and all, right? So they provided a single activity, take a screenshot. You can take a screenshot, the output may be a file, output may be a image object, output may be a clipboard, right? Clipboard, image object. So you can provide the image, right? You can create an image object here. Okay, file. So let us take a file. So this file, okay, screenshots, right? You can change the screen name of the, so Notepad. Okay, notepad.png. okay, so here if you don't provide anything, none, override, let us see here. So let us run. And here, I just take a Sudhir, just type the Sudhir, and it is taking the screenshot. See here, so which image it is taken, okay, notepad.image. See, Sudhir, it is taking that particular screenshot. So suppose if notepad.png is already there, let us try to run again, and Guru. Just type the Guru and it will take the screenshot. Let's go and check. So which image it is? See, it's overwriting the same image. See here, now it is a Guru, right? So overwriting the same image. So here the interesting is the increment. It is an index, the auto increment type index. So it's already there. The notepad.png is there. Let us try to do again. So what it will do, so Guru, right? Okay, so let us try to run. Hurry, run again. See here, notepad bracket open 1.png. okay, so now it will take notepad bracket open 2.png. see here, 2.png, this is a, right, it automatically increment. It will reduce us a little amount of the coding. So normally you have to take a increment variable, you have to increment I equal to I plus 1, and you have to do the notepad bracket open I plus I dot to string plus these things and all, but it automatically increments. Suppose for example, let's say, okay, so let's run. So if you just run, automatically it will take a screenshot and it will name it as a auto increment. It will first of all, it will find, so is there any number, what is the maximum number? See here, it's a 2 is there, right? 3, it is automatically incremented and taken the screenshot and save that image as a that particular image. So the next interesting thing is the date and time. See here, date and time. So if you just take a screenshot, okay, take a screenshot, so this will save as a file with the date and time. Okay, YYYY MM DD at HH hours, minutes and seconds, right? So normally we are doing the same things while the exception occurred, we are taking the screenshot, right? These kind of things. So you can do the in the single activity for the date, time, these things and all, right? So let us see, try to run again. And so try to modify, okay, so it will take the screenshot and name this screenshot name as the current time. And so anyway, it is a unique date and time is a unique thing. See here, Udaya, and previous one is a, this is a really very interesting thing. Okay, so let us take, so this suppose for example, so we give the only the file name. Only the file name, that file is taking storing the all the things in the that particular location. Let us try to do in this location, okay, slash error, okay, error. So let us try to run. So you don't need to specify anything, so that means error.png. so let us take, see here, let us see this error.png automatically came. Error.png automatically came. See here, increment. Let us try to run. Let us see, automatically it is incremented. Okay, so what about the date and time? So this is a file, okay, the file thing. So if you want to again go for the image object, so you can take the image objects, or if you want to take to the clipboard, suppose this is a clipboard, okay, so let us take that into, see, this is a, all things are, so you have to specify the normal name only at the end of the name, that means before .png and after the name, it will automatically do the all things like a, so date, time, these things all. So let us Sudhir, okay, this is a clipboard, now it's stored in the clipboard, okay. So let us check WinBoard. I'm just trying to paste that into the here, control B. See, it is a pasted, control B. So if I just paste, it is a pasted. Got it? So that is the new thing. So what is that? Take the use application activity within that text screenshot. Okay. Thank you very much. That is for today knowledge. So what I just want to share with you. So please subscribe. If you not are subscribed, click on the bell icon and please share my videos. If you want to do different kind of videos, what type of videos you are just looking from my end, so please let me know in the comment section.